Okay, for topic today that I would like to share with you is about life is a journey. This is the individual journey that everyone have. And also for life, we just have only one life in this world. So why we need to do every step with the mindfulness? We need to have more awareness to live step by step for having a good life. And a good journey will bring you to the good future. And also for the good moment, it can become the good past also. And if you see the picture right now, like the in New York City, have someday have snow come. It's like the obstacle in daily life that we cannot control. We cannot control the season. We cannot control the environment, sometimes climate change. But one thing that we can control ourselves. We can control our thoughts. We can control our speech. We can control our action. Just select good action that have benefit and have meaningful for ourselves. And if you see when the snow come, actually we move forward, right? But during the way, oh, have a lot of thing, a lot of thing like the obstacle that come to your daily life, but you have destination and then you need to move no matter what happened. On the way, on the journey, sometimes obstacles, sometimes problem, sometimes conflict, sometimes happy, sometimes unhappy. But please tell yourself, it's okay. It shall will pass in one day. It not stay with you forever. You can keep moving forward to the future by you step by step. Bit by bit, okay, just day by day. If you understand, please try number one. Life is a journey for this picture. No matter what challenge come, one day we will pass it. One day we will proud for ourselves that we can overcome all obstacles that happen in our life. And for the Buddha teaching, you know something that's very beautiful. Before become a Buddha, he is a prince. You might know his name, Prince Siddhartha. Prince Siddhartha. If you know his name, please type number 4 in the comment. Prince Siddhartha. That he have everything that the human have in that time, in the timeless. Like in the ancient time, 2,500 years ago, he is a prince, he is a human. So that's why he understand the human very well. Because the Buddha, he is a human before, yeah. And then for the journey of him, one day he go to outside. He go to outside. Actually, inside all have everything that very beautiful. The girl, the woman, everything is perfect. Have more money, have many stuff that can make him feel awesome. But one day, he would like to go to outside. And then when he go to outside, he saw the sickness people, the old age people. And then the dead people. And then he just had the question, oh, one day it will come to me, right? And his friend said, yes. One day you will become like that. One day you will become sickness people, you will become own people. You can become like the dead people. One day you will die, and then oh, it's very shocked because he have everything. It's very perfect in the palace, but when he saw the truth, is very suffering, and he would like to find a way. He tried many ways until he can find the middle way, the path that not too much, not too less. And from his journey, this is a beautiful journey because this is a journey that different from the people that live in this world. The journey of the Buddha is about the way that can liberation from suffering. It's very beautiful because we are the human. We have many suffering come. Each day we have the conflict, we have the problem, but if we have the question to ourselves, and if you can overcome suffering, so we can find true happiness within ourselves. And this is the guideline that the Buddha showed to us, the journey towards liberation from suffering. And also from this world, we learn this from him. The cycle of samsara. Samsara is mean we born again. If someone asks you, today have, right? How about yesterday? Have or not? It have. How about in the past? You born before? Maybe. Yeah, because yesterday it have. And also the cycle of samsara, which refers to the continuous cycle of birth, death, and rebirth. So everyone in this Zoom room, you have the moment like that. You become the student you born, like the small kid before, yeah. Like we born and the first thing that we did, we cry. First time that you born, you cry. If you ask your parent will say to you that when you born in the first time that you breathe in, you cry first. So the life is full of suffering since the day one that we born as a human being. So from this, the cycle of samsara, like the reflection, you can reflect, like the continuous cycle of birth, death, and rebirth. We had the moment like that before. And also, and then impermanence. This is the process that slowly to change. Sometimes you don't aware it, but one day you will aware when you look in the mirror, or you can look at your picture. Look at your picture and compare right now, right here, and the past. Something is changed. This is the truth, impermanence. Everything in life, including ourselves, is constantly changing and impermanent. We cannot stop the process of changing. It's changing all the time. Your body, your life, your people, your parent, your stuff, your home, your car, your pet, anything cannot stay in the same. But it's always changes all the time. You know, when I came back to my home, my hometown, actually during that time I lived in my hometown in Prachinburi, Thailand. And then when I become as a monk, almost 10 years, maybe Phansa 8, and then I back to my home. And I just change my room. I just see my room, it changes. Oh, I just aware. Oh, it's not the same. Actually, in the first thing that I leave, oh, everything is new for me. But when the time passed, I ordered as a monk, I come back to see my room again. It's not the same. Something is broken on the wall also. And sometimes my parents just being the color, the white color to paint it, to protect the broken of the wall. Yeah, and when we look to ourselves, it also change. It's not the same. If you would like to make it stay forever, it cannot. This is the process of the nature. One day you will become like the process of nature. Become like the nature and then have the new gen come, new generation. This is something that can make us living a meaningful life because we have limited time, not live forever. It's not a game, because when we die, we can born again. But for the real life, we just have only one life in this world. And we learn this from the journey. Interconnectedness. All beings are interconnected and interdependent. So everything that you did had the side effect to everyone surrounding around you. If you live together with your parent, when you do something, it have effect to them also. If you speak so loud, they will let you know, please, shh, like that, please, shh. And then when you connect with your friend, if you do something good, your friend will enjoy. But if you do something that not good, maybe your friend will upset and then feel unhappy with you. And this is the interconnectedness that we are the human. Everything that we did is send the effect to your thoughts, your speech, and your action. And people around you can touch it by the feeling. Like when you see the people, oh, why they feel happy? Why they feel unhappy? Maybe the environment that they live in this world. And also, we cannot live alone. We live together and have the sentence, beautiful sentence that I love so much. If you would like to walk far, walk alone. If you would like to, if you would like to walk fast, walk alone. If you would like to walk far, walk together. And we have connect to each other also. Especially for the Zoom room today, we come from different country, different background, different religion. And then we have the same place that we can connect by Zoom platform, interconnected. And don't forget to connect with your inner self, connect with your happiness inside. And then it can send to happiness outside. When everything inside is okay, outside you will be okay. Your thoughts, your speak, and your action. And also, this is the connect. That. And then from this, karma. Karma, this is the law of action. Our actions have consequences, shaping our present and future experience. Since you were young, like the baby until right now, we do many action, right? Something good, something not good, but it keep it in your experience. Keep it in your memory. If something not good, okay, just let go. Don't have the reason, don't have the reason to bring it back because it can make you feel bad. So we can keep only good karma or the good action in our life. And from this, if you know about the scientific, like the momentum, momentum. And the Buddha discover law of karma. This is the law of truth of the all human being that have this, our action that have consequence. And also Isaac Newton discover the law of gravity. If you know him, please type number 2. Like law of gravity is come from Isaac Newton, and law of karma it come from the Buddha. That we need to be mindful every action that we did, that we do, just be mindful because it have consequences and it can make the good experience or bad experience depend on the good karma and the bad karma also. It's about action. And then it will be like the momentum. From this thing, you can see like the orange thing. And then it just move to cast the white color. And then it can send the effect to make the white color move it. Yeah. And this that he discovered, the four noble truths. This is the truth identify the nature of suffering. So from this thing, it comes to everyone. Because we are the human, we have suffering. Or the four unhappiness truth. Suffering, it comes every single day. But we need to know. It just have four things that we need to aware. We need to pay attention to observe and also reflect. Number one, about the truth of suffering. The truth of suffering that happened to our life for the physical and mentally. For the physical, you can easily to see it. But for the mentally, it difficult. It comes from inside and is long more than physical. And then number two, the truth of the origin of suffering. This is the cause of suffering and cause of suffering. And then number three, the truth of cessation of suffering. And number four, the truth of the path to cessation of suffering, or the path that can overcome all suffering inside ourselves. If we compare about another version that is easy for you, it can call the four happiness truth. The four happiness truth. For number one, okay, everyone have a unhappiness. And then number two, we need to find the cause of unhappiness. Number three, we can find the sensation of unhappiness. And number four, this is the path that can make you have more happiness and can get rid unhappiness inside ourselves. If you clear for the four noble truths, please type number four in the comment also. If you understand the four noble truths, and then if you understand the four happiness, the four happiness truths. Okay. And then this is From this picture, you might understand clearly. It like the effect for the vulnerable tooth, and then because this, like the root, it is caused craving and attachment. And it is and is then called nirvana. And the path to achieve it, the eightfold path, or make it simple. I will share to you to make it simple. And this is the cause, craving and attachment, because everything is impermanent. Everything is impermanent. If you look everything around you, your stuff, your friends, your loved ones, your car, your home, everything is destroyed by themselves. So if we bring our mind to attach with all things that always changes all the time, maybe it can have effect to make our mind up and down. That's why sometimes we feel unhappy. Sometimes we feel happy because we have this thing to bring our mind to attach with all things, all stuff that always changes, like the impermanent. So when we know it's okay, we need to want less. Like become like the minimalism. Minimal is mean less is more. When you have less, you can have more space for your mind, for your body. You can have time for focus. What is matter for you right now? What is the good thing that we should do right now? This is the question that's very simple. But if we have more things in your daily life, we have everything. So we have this, it's not enough. We want more, it's not enough. Actually, it just feel good for the first time, but later you feel normal. And then the new thing come, and then you see the advertisement, it come, you need more to fulfill, but it's not fulfillment because it change it. And more, and most of the people, they bore. Yeah. And also, if we have less eat more, we can focus inside. We can focus the quality of our mind is beautiful more than outside factor that always change. But don't let the outside factor change your inner peace inside. And also, let us start the journey on 20, 24. From this number, it always change. Every year it changed. Like before, in the last year, 2023, right? But today, right now, on January 2024. And it like the starting month that we have, like the journey that we should to collect the good thing to prepare and learn from the previous year 2023. You can learn from the previous year for prepare for make it better on this journey on 2024. And like the new chapter that everyone have the one page. And today it comes to January 13, maybe page number 13. And then one day it can come to page number 366, yeah, on this year. So just keep it. Be happy along the way. Left side and right side, just enjoy for your life. Just use your journey for fulfill your life with the good thing. And then I will share the good thing to you for start the journey. Chi Wei, Chi Wei's for practice. Number one, giving. Number two, ethics. Number three, meditation. I will explain one by one. Okay, let's start with this. For the giving, it's easy. It's not difficult. You can give your time for someone to listen, to give the encouragement to someone when they need help, when they need encouragement. Just give time for listening. Give time for sharing good things. Good. Give time for share the story to them. And for the giving, just have only two people, right? One people is the people that give, and another person is about the receive. Yeah. Every time that you give, you put your good intention, you put your good energy to the stuff that you give to the people. For me, when I saw like the homeless people, sometimes I help them by give $1, share to them like the, okay, you need to be strong. Don't give up. Try to do the best for your life. And it's just the small thing, but I give about the good word to make them realize that, okay, you life is moving forward. You don't to give up, just try to do it. Yeah. And for the people around you, you can give something when people need help. Okay, come to help them, come to volunteer, come to visit. And from this month, I came to visit Marilyn and very happy. Yeah, because I saw the real Marilyn, like the three dimension, 3D. Yeah, and then, oh, it's very good to talk with Marilyn, to talk with, to pray with her cat and her share about her story. That's very meaningful for me to realize. And then she has a friend, like the children that come to visit her room. Yeah, something that I know deeply more than before. Yeah, when I visit her room. Yeah, something it easy to practice giving your give time for yourself to practice meditation. Give time for other people. Give time for take care your body, take care your mind. Give the good stuff to the people that need help. Or practice giving by donate the money to the non-profit organization that can bring the goodness, bring the good health to all people that need help. And then number two, ethics. Ethics, like the good conduct, like the moral conduct, like the five precepts that we need to practice. It's like the way that we be mindful. Before we do anything, be mindful. It's about the select. Select to do, and you know, oh, is it good thing to do? Okay, just do. But is it a bad thing to do? Not do it. Yeah. And this is a caring. Caring culture. Caring for life, not harm yourself, not harm ourselves, not harm other people, because we are the human being. We are face fear. We love our life. So we love our stuff that we have. So just put ourselves in the another shoe. We will understand the meaning of this good conduct, ethics. Just do it. Just don't do it. Because if you do it, it can make you feel good and make other people feel good. But if something wrong, just stop it. Don't do it, because it harm yourself first and harm other people when you look back, or you will regret later. Just feel sorry later is not good. It not be mindful. Just protect before do it. And for the last one, meditation. Meditation is very necessary thing that we should to practice every day, like the way that we practice showering the body. We shower the body every day because we would like to get rid of dust that stick in the skin. That we go to outside, we have a lot of pollution that stick it at your skin. So when we come back to your to our room, and then the first thing that we did, okay, go to shower the body to feel fresh. Sometime in the morning, sometime in the evening, it's the easy way to do, and it's free. Everywhere we can practice the room. When I go to outside, I practice accident path, just close the eye, enjoy the nature. It's easy thing that we can practice. And for the meditation, this is the process that can develop the mind, develop the loving kindness, develop the good compassion to ourselves. And when we have good inner peace inside, we can share it to the people, because inside it will be okay. When the mind is will be okay, it like the water that clear. You can see everything clear. You can see the pebble. You can see the fish. You can see the duck that swim. And then when the mind clear, you can understand yourself clearly. You can learn how to stop. You can learn how to control your emotion, control your thoughts, control your speech, and control your action. So that's why meditation is a good thing that we need to practice every day, every time, if we can.